Let's start with this. I talked about the fact we need to reform student loans. I owed over $100,000 in student loans. The day I got elected to the Senate, I had over $100,000 still in student loans that I was able to pay off because I wrote a book. And from that money, I was able to pay it. If not, it would never, I'd still be paying it. Okay. So that's not about, I think the student loan thing in America is a big problem and it's broken and it needs to be fixed and it needs to be reformed.
Okay, don't have your debt canceled, just become a senator and get a big advance on a book. Sounds like stupid advice, but you should understand that apparently the question he was answering was, can you be a successful politician and tell people to pull themselves up by the bootstraps? And he did answer the question, no, you apparently cannot do that without looking like an absolute doink. Although as Shuli pointed out, technically, he pulled himself up by his bookstraps, which is true. Now, the idea that you should just write a book and get a massive advance is ridiculous enough, but it does give us an opportunity to remind you that the entire thing of politicians and commentators in politics generally writing books is ripe with corruption. It is ridiculous and it is corrupt. His book, by the way, Marco Rubio, back in 2013, he published An American Son, a Memoir. He got an $800,000 book advance. And I wanna ask you a question. Have you ever met a person who has read that book? No, you have not. I'll answer that for you. Why do they get these big advances? Why do these books serve as bestsellers when nobody ever reads them? Well, we have some videos up on the channel. I did a multi-part series breaking down Don Trump Jr. and his scam. They basically use nonprofits on the right to buy up a bunch of their books in massive quantities to simulate demand for it. And there is even a special symbol on the New York Times bestseller to mark when this is done. It's a little dagger. You can go right now and you can see it in a number of books. When a political commentator on the right has a book that goes bestseller, unless it's like Glenn Beck, it's like 90% chance that it's all a fiction. They're not bestsellers. Nobody's reading these books. They're bought up in mass quantities and then they're thrown into the dump. That's what it is. It happened for Marco Rubio. And if it could happen for every student, I'd be in for it. I just don't think that's how it's gonna work.
Also, whoever owns Hudson News is a raging Republican donor POS. Like that person absolutely hates, I mean, they hate all travelers, really, because have you ever been like stuck? I would not read Marco Rubio's book if I were stuck in a layover for a week and it was the only thing on display at Hudson. Okay, I would probably, but I would like live stream it and we'd make jokes and it'd be funny. But you should watch those videos. This is like John Iadarola's John Oliver moment. That is very important to remember. You can just, you can buy off the New York Times bestseller list. Clutches non-existent pearls.
Yeah. Yeah, and you might ask, by the way, watch those videos. They're up on the channel and I think we did a pretty good job. Why do this? Well, do you know how nice it is to be able to say, I'm a New York Times bestseller? All of them do it. Nobody reads their books, but it is a way to literally take a certain amount of money and turn it into an aura of respectability. That's all it is. And it's totally legal. You can totally do it. And the New York Times is complicit in this. They have the symbol because they know it's a con. What you could do is not listed as a bestseller. How about that? That's a hell of a symbol for you.
Where do the books land?
Why not actually, what's that?
Where do the books land? Like, do they land in the same place that like the
bin?
Yeah, or like, you know, rural communities in like Uganda where like the t-shirts of like, you know, teams that don't win the pennant cup, you know what I mean? Like that, or the Stanley Cup, or you know what I mean? Like it's like that and Marco Rubio's. Or just like is it the students of Florida who are like, they can only read right wingers' memoirs. Like,
exactly. Yeah.
I'm sorry to interrupt, John. Well, it's funny to me.
No, it's cool. I know it's ridiculous. Something needs to be done about it, but it's still, we did those videos like 2 years ago. It's still any number of right wing bestsellers since then. Anyway,
John,
with that said, we do have to take our last break. Okay, super fast.
Super fast. You have to be a right winger in order to write the right book. Remember how Bernie Sanders wrote a book and they were like, how dare you make money from that book?
Oh, 100%. Yeah. Yeah, and I bought his book, by the way. That was an authentic sale. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.